Hello. When we feel like we have little time to stretch our bodies, we'd love to do more yoga if we could, but we just don't think we have the time. You want an exercise that's going to power pack your body. This one will stretch the hamstrings, the hips, and the lower back. The three areas that I hear most from my clients about ways, you know, where it feels painful. So let's stretch all three of those together at once. Grab your strap or a hand towel or a tie or a piece of string, whatever, lay down on your back and take that strap around your right leg. Lift it up to the sky and try to keep your knee straight. If your knee is bent, then you will not get as much of a stretch in the hamstring. And this is why we have the strap. There's no need to feel like you have to grab your toe. If you can, great, but don't worry about it if you can't. The strap is going to do the work. We'll hold this pose for about 5 breaths, and we can feel that deep stretch along the back of the hamstring. Plus, we're pulling our leg toward our body a little bit, so it's lengthening out the curve of the spine. A really nice release for the low back. Slow and steady inhales and exhales as we go. Good. And then gently open up your leg to the right. Here we get into our hip, the inner thigh and hip, right through the groin and through that hip socket. Again, there's a beautiful space in the low back as well. So we're widening out the gap between our hips to release a little bit of pressure in the hips there. And we hold and we breathe. And if you notice that it's getting a little bit easier to release that leg toward the floor, let it happen. Gravity is on our side here with our strap laying on the ground. Good. Now come back to the center and let's switch our hands. So we have our left hand in our strap, on our strap, and we're pulling that right leg across the body toward the floor. For me, this is the hardest one. You can feel it through the outer hip all the way down into the hamstring. This IT band runs all the way down to the ankle. And again, the straighter that you have the knee, the better you'll feel the stretch. Then what's also lovely is this right shoulder gets involved as you pull that right shoulder to the floor. We're getting a nice upper back stretch and chest and shoulder stretch. See how power-packed this sequence is? And it's really going to take you only about 5, maybe 10 minutes if you hold each pose for a good while. I'll leave that up to you. Beautiful. Now let's bring our leg back to the center and we're going to hold on and lift our head. This time it will engage our abdominals. So we're curving our spine, pressing that curve of the floor to the ground for a little back relief and a little engagement through the psoas and lower abdominals. One more hamstring stretch pull here as well. Inhale, exhale, come on down. Nicely done, let's switch sides. We have to make sure we're balanced. So now that left foot in the strap. You might notice that each side feels a little bit different. A little bit different tension along the hamstrings or the hips. Generally, we have one side that's maybe a little more flexible than the other. But we give each side equal opportunity to stretch out. Very nice. Let's open that left leg to the left side so we have the strap in our left hand pulling open to the side. And we can really feel that inner thigh and groin, that internal rotator of the hip. You can extend your right arm out to the side to help you stay balanced, or even take your right hand to your hip if you feel like you are rolling toward the floor. And the longer we hold, the deeper our breath becomes, and maybe the more release we will get through that outer hip. It's It's almost like that hurts so good feeling, right? We know it's necessary to stretch all this out. It's going to make us feel better later. Good. Now let's come back to the center. Switch our hand. So we've got the right hand on the strap and pull to the right. You can feel that outer right hip, that IT band. It runs all the way down to the ankle. We're getting a nice twist in our back and we're extending out the left arm to get that shoulder and chest pull. Whew, this one's hard for me. I gotta focus on my breath. I'm always tight in this area, but I love the way it feels on my back. Hopefully there's something to find that we love about each of these poses. Very nice. Let's come back to the center. Grab on with both hands, lift our head. We're engaging our abdominals, feeling that curving of the spine. One more nice power pull for that hamstring. Take a breath, inhale, exhale, release. Nicely done. You have now successfully stretched the three tightest areas of the body. At least that's what my clients say. Hips, low back, and hamstrings, all in one powerful stretch that will take you less than 10 minutes.